So, in today's particular lecture, we will be solving questions from miscellaneous exercise 1. This is also the last section of your Udemy course. Select the correct option using the given alternatives. The first question, 22 pi by 15 radian is equal to what? A, B, C or D option? There are four alternatives. Among those, we need to solve and get the answer. So let's begin. So we know how to convert radian measurement into degree measurement. So theta is equals to 22 pi by 15 into 180 by pi. This is the question we shall follow. So in this particular thing, basic cancellations and calculations will happen. Pi and pi will get cancelled. 15 and 180 will get cancelled to get 12. Now if you multiply 22 with 12, you will get 4. Cross multiply, 2 into 2, 4, 6. 6 and 2. So your answer comes out to be 264 degrees. This is your answer. Okay. So answer is B. Make sure you note it down. We'll move to the next one. Second question. 156 degrees is equal to what? So over here we need to calculate in terms of radians. So we will convert our given question to radian. 156 degrees into pi by 180 degree. Okay. So let's start with the cancellation process. Bit of calculative, nothing else. Cancel it. It goes by 3's table, right? So it will be 60 over here. It will be 52 over here. 52 and 60. We are having two things. Okay. So this one goes by 2. So this will be 2 and 1, 26. This one goes by 2 as well, 30. Cancel it further. This goes by again, 13 it comes, again 15. So your answer is 13 pi by 15 radian, which is actually option B. So option B is your answer. Mark it, note it down. We'll move to the third question. Third question on your screen. So the third question, a horse is tied to a post by a rope. If the horse moves along a circular path, always keeping the rope tight, and describes 88 meters. So 88 meters is actually S, length of the arc covered by the horse. And length of the rope given over here, which we need to find, it will be R. It will act like radius. When it traces the angle of 72 degrees at the center. So 72 degrees, this is our theta. So simple, basically here's the horse. This is the rope. The horse traces a circular path with keeping an angle of 72 degree at the center. 88 meters are covered as length of the arc. We need to find length of the rope, which is unknown. Theta is in terms of degrees. We need to apply S equals to R theta, for which theta should be in terms of radians. So 72 into pi by 180. Okay. Cancel it out. You will get 2 and 5. So that will be 2 pi by 5. Radian, 2 pi by 5 radian. So R is equals to theta upon S upon theta. R is equals to S upon theta. This can be solved as 88 divided by 2 pi divided by 5. Now, pi does the somersault, it goes up in the numerator. 88 into 5 divided by 2 into 27, 22 by 7. 22 by 7 is value of pi. Remember, pi for numerical calculation, for numbers, it is equal to 22 by 7. But when we are calculating degrees, it is 180 degree. Okay. 22 by 7, that's the value of pi we are using. So let's do the calculative part. 22 and 8 get 88 get cancelled for 4. 2 and this thing, 4 will get cancelled for 2. 7 goes up, gets multiplied with pi, it becomes 35. 35 into 2, your answer is 70 meters. Your answer for this particular question is 70 meters. So A is the answer. You can note down these calculations and mark the answer. Now we will move to the next sum, fourth one. Okay, the fourth question. A pendulum of 14 centimeters long oscillates through an angle of 12 degrees. So when they are saying 14 centimeters, It basically means this is the radius. This is the radius as 14 centimeters for the circular path. S equals to r theta. The concept remains the same. Then the angle of path described by its extremities is what? Now they are asking us to find angle of the path described by extremities. Indirectly, they are asking us to find, just a minute. So the pendulum is oscillating through 12 degrees. Then the angle of the path described by its extremities is what? This is what they're asking us. Fine. Let's use our brain. Let's be calculative and let's do it. So first of all, we need to convert 12 into radian. So sorry, into this thing. What do you call? Yeah, in radian. So 12 and 180 get cancelled. You are having 2 left here. You are having 30 left here. Cancel it. You will get your answer in terms of pi by 15. Your answer comes out to be pi by 15 radians. So we need to find S. S equals to r theta. So S is equals to 14 into pi by 15. Your answer is S equals to 14 pi by 15. Okay, that's your answer. Answer is B. They're asking us to find path. That means they're asking us to find S, length of the arc covered. So answer is D. Let's move ahead. This one. Angle between hands of a clock when it shows the time 9.45 is what? So let's do this. This will be interesting. We'll draw a shape, a circular one. This is the circular one. Then let's mark the hands. Where will be the hands? We are talking about 9:45. 9 is here and 45. So it is basically 15 minutes before 10. Somewhere over here will be the center of the clock. Let's draw the minute hand and hour hand with different inks. I'll draw the hour hand with black ink. The hour hand is quite near to 10, okay? Whereas the minute hand will be exactly at 9. The minute hand, let's draw it with red ink. The minute hand will be at red. So this is the minute hand, okay? And the black one is the hour hand, okay? This is the case. Now we need to find angle between both. We don't know the angle between both. This will be quite interesting. As you know, angle between two consecutive marks on a clock is basically 30 degrees. So if I have to say angle between 9 and 10 marking, 9 and 10 mark on clock will be equal to 30 degrees, right? Out of which 45 minutes have been covered. 45 minutes after 9 have been completed or covered, okay, by the clock, which indicates that 3/4 of an hour is covered. 3/4 of an hour is covered. And in 1 hour, it is possible to cover how many degrees? 30 degrees, right? 30 degrees. So if we cancel this out, if we do our maths, 2, 15, 45 by 2, what do you get? Cancel it. You will get 22.5 degrees. Got it? So answer is D. This is your answer. I hope you understood the logic. Basically, after 9 o'clock, we have covered 45 minutes more. So basically, our R end will be 3/4 ahead. So that means 22.5 degrees is the answer between them. Okay. So note it down. We'll move ahead. Of wire is available for fencing of a flower bed. It is not fencing, it is basically fencing. Correct it? In form of a circular sector of radius 5 meters, then the maximum area in square meter of the bed is how much? So 20 meter of wire is available for fencing. So this 20 meter acts as S. This 20 meter will act as S. Length of the arc. Radius will be R equals to 5. So the formula for area of the sector. Area of sector is given by 1 by 2 R square theta. But we can write it as 1 by 2 RS. 1 by 2 RS. Which is equal to 1 by 2. In place of R, let's substitute 5. In place of S, we will substitute 20. Cancel it out. 10 remaining. Your answer is, so we need to take S equals to 20 minus 2R. S equals to 20 minus 2R. S will not be exactly 20. It will be 2R. The reason is, when you draw a particular sector, there are two radius components, R, and then remaining part. This is equal to S equals to 20 minus 2R. So S equals to 20 minus R into 5, 20 minus 2R, 2 into 5, which will be 10. Okay. So over here, 1 by 2 into R. R is basically 5 into 10. Cancel it out. 5. 25 meters square. This is the thing. Answer is C. 25 meters square. Okay. So make sure you note it. S is equals to 20 minus 2R. So next question. 7th one. If the angles of a triangle are in the ratio 1 is to 2 is to 3, then the smallest angle in radian is what? Let's find it. This will be interesting. For example, there's a triangle as given here. The angles are x, 2x, and 3x. I assume the angles to be in the ratio 1 is to 2 is to 3, where x is a common multiple. Okay. Now, how do we know sum of all angles of a triangle? Sum of all angles of a triangle, say ABC, upper one is A, B, and then C. A plus B plus C gives you pi radians. This particular thing is going to be x plus 2x plus 3x is equals to pi. So that will be 6x is equals to pi. That means x will be equal to pi by 6. So we have got x equal to pi by 6. The smallest angle is actually A, which will be x equal to pi by 6 in the ratio 1. So answer is B. Mark it. Note it down. We'll move to the next question. 8th one, a semicircle is divided into two sectors whose angles are in the ratio 4 is to 5. Find the ratio of their areas. This is pretty much easy. If you want, you can draw a diagram for better understanding. Okay, so this is the circle we are talking about. This particular circle is a semicircle. So there will be a division. So the area below the semicircle is not of our concern. Okay. This particular area is not of our concern. The only concern is the above part. Now they have said the upper part, which is the semicircle, only this much, is divided into two sectors whose angles are in the ratio 4 is to 5, somewhat like this. That means this particular is 4 theta. This particular angle becomes 5 theta. Okay. Now they have told us to find area of their sectors and their ratios. So A1 and A2. We need to know about A1 and A2. It's pretty simple. Area of a sector is given by 1 by 2 R square theta, which indicates area of any sector is directly proportional to theta, the angle. Okay. So I can say A1 upon A2 will be equal to 4 by 5 as well. So answer turns out to be B. This was very simple one, a formula based. Answer is B. Okay, note it down. Very much straightforward. Okay. Next one, 9. they have told us to find measure of the angle between hour hand and minute hand of a clock at 20 minutes past 2. 20 minutes past 2, basically 2:20. The time is 2:20. Let's do this. It will be anything lesser than 60. Using common sense, we can say that the angle will be anything lesser than 60 and not exactly equal to 60. The possible answers turn out to be option A and option C, but we will do calculative work and we won't speculate the answers. Okay. So 2 o'clock is over here. Our hand will be at somewhere ahead of 2, a bit ahead of 2. 4 o'clock over here, this is 3. The minute hand is exactly at 4 for 2:20, right? We need to get this angle. So it will be something lesser than 60. How? See, between the marking of 2 and between the marking of 4, it will be 2 times 30 degrees. As the time to be as the angle to be calculated is between 2 consecutive markings of the clock. So one consecutive marking, that is between 2 and 3, the angle will be 30 degrees. And between 3 and 4, the angle will be 30 degrees. So 30 plus 30 gives you 60. So we need to subtract something from 60 to get exact angle. The reason is, when the time is 2 past 20, 1/3 of 30 degrees is already reduced. 1/3 of 30 degrees is already reduced. So let's do this. Angle will be equal to 60 degrees minus, see, 1/3, I'm talking about 1/3 of 30 degrees is reduced. Or you can say 20 minutes of the 60 minutes in 1 hour are already passed. So 20 minutes of 60 minutes of 1 hour are already passed. And accordingly, we need to get our answer. This one, 3, cancel it out, 10. It will be 60 minus 10, which is equal to 50 degrees. So answer is A. Answer is A. Note it down. Pretty much straightforward. So the angle lost over here is 10 degrees. So the angle between red and the black line is 10 degrees. The little gap over there. Okay. Note it down. We'll move ahead. So 10th question, central angle of a sector of circle of area. So this is area of circle given to us, not area of sector. So that will be pi r square. That will be pi r square. And theta is given to us. Theta is over here. It's unknown. Let's begin the calculation. Area of sector is given to us. Sorry, area of circle is given to us. We need to find few values. First one is r. We don't know the radius. We need to get the radius. But we know that theta is 60. We know theta is 60. R is. We need to find perimeter. Now, what is perimeter? Perimeter is equal to 2 times radius plus s. That is length of the arc covered. Okay. So let's calculate. Theta is equal to 60 into pi by 180. We are converting angle to radian. So that will be pi by 3. We need to calculate r. R is missing. Okay. What will be r? Area of circle is given to us. Area of circle is given to us. That will be pi r square is equals to 9 pi centimeter square. Pi and pi will get cancelled. We will have r is equals to 3. So r will be equal to 3. So s equals to r theta. That will be 3 pi by 3. You have multiplied this, cancel it out. S is equals to pi. We got value of s as equal to pi. We need to find A, area of sector, half r square theta. Okay. That will be 1 by 2 into r square becomes 9 into pi by 3. Cancel it out, 3. Okay, that's it. No further calculations as we can see. Do we need, no, I think we won't need area over here. We just need S. Once we have got S, it's done. We won't require area. So let's not calculate it. Fine, so let's find perimeter. That is 2r plus s. That is 2r plus s. That becomes 2 into, what is r? 3. Plus what is s? It is pi. That becomes 6 plus pi. Your answer turns out to be c. So c is your answer. Note it down. This is your answer. That's the solution on your screen. We will meet in the next lecture. That will be the final lecture on this chapter, and we will complete remaining sums of miscellaneous. Thank you so much, guys. Meet you in the next lecture.